So in today's video, we're going to be looking at maximum demand and diversity. And the method we're going to use really is from the on-site guide and guidance notes 3. Okay, and it's actually quite a nice, easy method in most cases, just to give us a general idea of what the maximum demand is. I like to use this method because especially when you're on site and you're filling out an EIC or an EICR, you can just use your calculator on your phone. There's no crazy calculations to do as such. Obviously, there's different methods of doing maximum demand and diversity, which we'll look at in further videos. However, this one is just a generic one, which we're gonna use. So it's a house renovation. It's only a little one bedroom house. They currently have economy 7, but the renovators wanna get rid of the storage heaters and put in electrical panel heaters in their place. So what we're gonna do is remove the economy 7 board, and we're just going to replace the old board anyway, and we're going to incorporate them circuits into the new board, okay, because they're already in place. The testing has been done on them, so the insulation resistance etc is fine. So we're just going to prove that basically, because we're now adding two extra circuits into a board, okay, it's 25 mil tails, it is 100 amp cutout fuse, we're just going to prove that it doesn't have an issue, make an issue with the maximum demand of the property. So we've got the old circuits here and these are the new circuits, okay? Most of them are the same. As you can see, there's just two extra 16 amp circuits. And what we're gonna do is the method from the on-site guide, which basically we're gonna take 100% of the largest circuit we have, okay? So in this installation is a 32 amp. There's multiple of them, so we'll just take one of them. And then what we'll do is we'll do 40% of the remainder. So we'll add up, so if we took away that one, we'll add up the rest of the circuits, find 40%, and then we'll add the 100% to the 40%, which will give us a maximum demand calculation. And again, this is just a nice, easy method that you can use while you're on site using your calculator. So just before we move on to actually doing our calculation, just wanted to show you what these would equal if we didn't apply diversity. So our maximum demand for the old setup would be 140 amps, and for the new setup would be 172 amps. Now that's not gonna be any good to us because we have a 100 amp cutout fuse. However, what we're going to do is we're going to apply diversity, okay, because not everything will be on 24 hours of the day, every day of the year using its full load current, okay? So we're going to apply diversity and we'll see what that does to these values. So as you can see, what we've done first, as we just sort of briefly talked about, is we took 100% of the largest circuit, okay, which is 32 amps. We've then took 40% of the remainder of the circuits, okay? So 40% of the remainder of the circuits added together, okay? So 40%, if we added all them circuits together, not the 32 amps of the largest one we already took, we would get 108 amps. If we take 40% of 108 amps, the easiest way to do that is multiply 108 by 0.4, would give us 43.2 amps. So if we added our largest circuit of 32 amps to the remainder of our circuits, okay, with the diversity included, would actually give us 75.2 amps. Now for the new layout with the extra circuits, again, we take 100% of the largest circuit, 40% of the remainder. Again, we add all of these together. We don't add the largest circuit we've already took. 40% of 140 amps, which is what these equal to, is actually 56 amps now. Okay, so we've added two circuits, but and you can see that it's actually increased from 43.2 to 56. So we add the 32 amps to the 56 amps, which actually gives us a maximum demand, including our diversity, of 88 amps. So as you can see, it's a nice, easy calculation, one you can really do on your phone while you're on site. And we use this from the on-site guide, and generally in a domestic dwelling, we can do it this way, as long as they're in the circuits arrangements are in accordance with Appendix H of the on-site guide. So do we have A1 ring final circuits, etc. So now we've done our calculations with applying diversity, we can go back and look at the difference now. So it's definitely a significant difference. So 140 amps without applying diversity to our maximum demand. And when we apply a form of diversity, we get 75.2. And again, down here for the new one, this is the one we're worried about the most, okay, just to make sure that we can do what we're proposing to do. Without diversity, 172 amps. However, when we apply it, it's actually only 88 amps. Okay, so that means we can continue with our proposed plans. It's not going to have too much of a major effect on the installation. As always, we hope this video has been some help.